Fighting broke out in Venezuela's parliament last week, Tuesday, leaving one lawmaker bloodied and bruised. The incident reflects the country's ongoing dispute over last month's presidential election results. The fracas was apparently triggered by a measure in the government-controlled National Assembly to block opposition members' right to speak until they recognized new President Nicolas Maduro's victory. Mr. Michael Flood, regional coordinator of Uniori, an organization which monitors elections in the Caribbean and Latin America, has condemned the behavior of the parliamentarians, calling it absurd. But at the same time, he says those who feel they were cheated in the elections will react unfavorably.
Once people believe that they have their power in hand, they will do whatever they want. And those who believe that they were robbed of democracy, again, they will react. I need to say that I think it is a situation where the powers that be need to visit very, very, very soon. I know, as per our report that was submitted to our various organizations, they are looking into it, and I'm sure all eyes are on the Parliament of Venezuela to ensure that, you know, it does not escalate to a lot worse than it is now.
Mr. Flood says on the day of elections, when new President Nicolas Maduro was eventually declared winner, supporters of a particular party were engaged in electoral activities within the 200 exclusion zone, although the Venezuelan army was out in full force. Opposition candidate Henrique Capriles lost the election to Nicolas Maduro by fewer than 300,000 votes, or 1.5 percentage points, according to results issued by Venezuela's National Electoral Council. But the Venezuelan opposition leader has not yet conceded the narrow loss, claiming that thousands of irregularities had occurred on election day and demanding a recount. Mr. Michael Flood feels that once it is perceived that there is no democracy, things like that will happen. He recounts an incident during the inauguration of the new president where the microphone was grabbed out of his hand.
I am sure you will recall my report after the elections and what happened. Also, if one were to pay attention to what happened at the inauguration of the president, where someone literally ran on the stage and took the mic from him. It is because the perception in Venezuela is that the process of the last general elections was undemocratic, and people still have that gut feeling that they will do whatever it takes to ensure that democracy prevails.
Mr. Flood is currently attending a conference of the Organization of American States in Barbados, where the registration of political parties and campaign financing are being discussed. He was also part of an observer team to the recent presidential elections in Venezuela. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.